There's a grand tradition of fearless TV correspondents in Australia. An event would take viewers into war zones. Mm-hmm. Sarah Ferguson on the ABC has stared down world leaders, and our very own Denise Scott has proved time and time again that as our Melbourne correspondent, she's also not afraid to tackle the big stories. Here is her latest report.
Hello there, Denise Scott, Melbourne correspondent for Studio 10. I've done some tough assignments. I had my date with The Bachelor. I walked the catwalk with a model. But now, here I am at the Royal Melbourne Show in the biggest showbag pavilion in the world. Will I be able to handle it? Guess we'll see. The Royal Melbourne Show has been bringing the country to the city for over 170 years. Hundreds of thousands of people each year get a sugar high from the show bags, go wild on the rides, get up close with animals, and no visit to the Royal Show is complete without visiting the CWA ladies. And now you are Marion and you're the...
State President.
The State President. I curtsy before you. Last year, the Country Women's Association sold 15,000 scones at the show, and it's a record the gals want to beat this year. Joy from Terrelgan, get over here, Joy. Come on, Joy. Apparently, Joy is the main scone maker here, the champion scone maker. What's the secret to a good scone, Joy?
Don't overhandle them.
Don't overhandle them. I've heard that said about other things, Joy, but not. It's not for the seat. Oh, look at you. Look at you, Marion. You look as though you're disapproving of me. And you, do you put the jam or cream first?
Agreed, it's jam first. But what we also need to train just one or two of our guests is that one breaks a scone. One does not cut a scone.
Did we get a close-up of the breaking of the scone? That's beautiful work. I'll eat that, don't you worry. Daryl, I'm so thrilled to meet you. This is your farm that you bring to the Royal Show every year?
I do, yes. This is the fourth year that we've been involved.
Shut up over there! can you control your ducks?
Of course I can't, and they're geese.
Oh. I'm a real animal person.
You're a real animal person for sure. This is the fourth year that we've been involved with the show. So we bring 200 animals down, and sometimes the geese will cackle and you make a bit of a performance. People are able to walk past and just have a look and see what our farm looks like. This is Denise the goat, of course.
Oh, it is not.
It is so. Look at her. Oh. It's adorable.
It sure is. Hello, Denise the goat. And, is that a goat?
Oh, well, that's why I bring that particular one. It's a Persian sheep and it's a desert sheep. And you can see he's got fat underneath his chin and fat on his tail. And he stores...
Oh, don't talk to me about fat underneath the chin and the tail, Farmer Darrell.
Well, it's just our age. When the conditions turn bad, he's able to live off the condition off his body.
So if things go awry... I'm in good shape, Farmer Darrell.
Well, we both are. We'd be right for, maybe a 10-year drought for sure.
Speak for yourself. My new mate, Farmer Darrell, tried his best to introduce me to life on his farm, but nothing could have prepared me for an encounter with Lily the Llama.
Oh, hello, beautiful.
I'm married. Well, sort of. Actually, we just live together. Lily, I'm also heterosexual. But thank you. I appreciate the interest. This is one of the most intimate moments I've had in years.
No visit to the show is complete without checking out the dog shows, where breeders from around the country compete for a variety of ribbons. And this correspondent learnt that dog showing is a very serious business.
Well, here I am in the dogs pavilion with Darren, the dog breeder, stroke handler, stroke shower.
Yes, I suppose you could say that. A jack of all trades.
And and, of course, Melody here.
Yes, the gorgeous Unchained Melody, who won her intermediate bitch class today at the Melbourne Royal.
Did you know she was an intermediate bitch when you first saw Melody?
She's a beautiful bitch, and she's...
I'm sorry, Darren. I've tried to keep this together, but no.
She is a beautiful bitch.
So, Darren, what's it like in the dog world?
It's a tough one. It's a very competitive sport.
Yeah.
It's a win at all costs sometimes.
Can you show us your show face? Like, if you're about to go into the ring now.
You're very serious and you're staunch and you're concentrating on what you're doing.
I like it. You're a winner.
I like you too.
I've had a really sexy day at the Royal Show.
You could almost be my best bitch.
I'm a bit phobic, but I'm going to do it. I'd like a ticket to the most terrifying ride at the show.
I think I know which one. It'll be the ride that'll be suitable, perfect just for you.
Oh, wish
me
luck.
We're going to go just over there.
Okay.
All the best.
Thank you.
Born to be
wild.
Born to be wild.
Was hysterical from woe to go.
I had a great
funny.
Time.
Oh, you can tell.
I think that's the best package we've ever done.
Oh.
That's a show.
Well,
that is a... I mean, you know that already.
I already know that. Oh. Of course, there's a logie in that.